Can I ask a question to Dylan? If you can take it seriously?
I mean, you guys are going to talk about it.
Alright.
How many colors do I think
I have? I got an essay to write home. I kind of want.
Okay, alright. We'll make it quick. It has to last for like 10 minutes or so.
Okay.
I'm
not actually in a hurry.
Alright.
I'm just trying to get Dylan to do stuff.
Okay, so guys, I wrote a book last quarter called Native Son. And basically, it was about this guy who was in like the 1930s and 40s.
Sorry,
I can't believe you. But no, it was a really interesting book. And it was about this guy who was, he was a black guy, and he was living in like this white community. And basically, his entire life was just fueled by fear. And like, fear just kind of ruled his entire life, because he got like a job offer to work for these like really rich white people. But the thing was, he was so afraid of like doing something wrong that he ended up doing something wrong because of his fear. So basically, like, just that's just the moral of the whole story, is that his fear ruled his life, and he ended up making these like terrible mistakes of killing people and stealing and all that sort of jazz, right?
What was he afraid of?
What was he afraid of?
Yes,
that's a really good question. You know, I've kind of thought about it, but it's more of just like, he was afraid of white society itself. Like, he saw the whole white community as like a white force that was just like pressing on him, you know, because they always looked down on him. So that's basically what he was afraid of, I guess. And plus, you know, back in those days, he was really unfair towards black people.
Good answer.
Yeah. But anyway, so basically, that was his entire life, and he was just running because of all these bad things that he did. And I wanted to kind of relate that towards the Bible and how it's like, you know, sometimes we become really afraid of the things that happen in our lives and the different pressures that come onto us. And we just like, we end up making like even worse decisions because of the fear that we have inside of ourselves, if that makes sense. So I wanted to read you guys this little like devotional that I found on the Bible app. I thought was really cool. Yeah, so this one is titled Follow Your Faith and Not Your Fear. And I'm just going to read through it. It's kind of long. Bear with me. So,
sorry.
Only do not rebel against the Lord, nor fear the people of the land, for they are our bread. Their protection has departed from them, and the Lord is with us, so do not fear them. And so this is basically directed towards Moses, and this is what Moses was saying. He was saying, Moses sent 12 spies into the promised land to scout it out, and upon their return, all 12 agreed that the land truly was flowing with milk and honey, as the Lord had promised. However, 10 of the 12 were fearful because the land was possessed by giants, examples like Goliath and stuff. But only two of the spies, Joshua and Caleb, came back with positive report, and they were the ones in the verse who say, do not fear them. And now keep this in mind, that these are all the same people who had witnessed firsthand the Passover and the parting of the Red Sea, that they were still afraid and still gave a bad report about these giants that they saw. And it says in Numbers 13:31, we are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we. And that's what the 10 that came back and they said. So needless to say, this did not go over well with God, because he had already promised them this land to the Israelites. And now they didn't even want to go in the land because they were afraid that they couldn't match up for these people. And basically, one thing you must know is that God has never failed to keep his promises. And it says in 1 Kings 8:56, there he has not failed one word of all his good promises. So God will always, like, moral of the story, he's always going to be there for us. And so, like, kind of my question is like, what are some things that you feel like that you're afraid of, basically, or something that's like, that's haunting over you and kind of controlling your decisions and stuff?
Gary? I mean, Kevin? Clunk?
Alvin? Need money or college. Mm-hmm. You might be able to afford going to college. So like scholarships and actually having to apply for them. But having to manage that with school, like, I don't know, at times I don't get so much. So it's like scary that I need to apply for scholarships to be able to go to college, but I can't spend time doing that to go to college. Gotcha.
Yeah.
It's scary.
Fitting in and succeeding at my school. Like, there's like a lot of it's a lot of kids there that are like all their life they've been like striving to do like really good in school. So, like I haven't always done that, and so I don't always like fit in at my school because like I'm not like the kids at my school that much, and so like it's like hard to like succeed. And a lot of the classes are a lot harder than I've been used to in the past, and then getting like used to the new students that like I've never been around and like fitting in.
For me, I think it's just like just grades and like homework itself recently, because like I think this year has been the hardest year for me in terms of like academics and stuff, and it's just been like the lowest my grades have ever been, and it's kind of like discouraging.
Wait till next year
senior year.
Last year I had 4 APs. This year I had 5 APs, and then they had the senior project class, which was like a ton of work outside of class, like outside of school that you had to take care of.
Mm-hmm.
So that took away homework time, and then you have 5 APs that you're like struggling for. And so like, and then you have to apply to colleges, and then once you get that done, then you have to do something else like outside of school that takes time, and it's just like a lot more stress. Planning that takes forever. Like the academics aren't much harder, but there's just so much more that you have to get done that it makes it harder. That in my opinion.
Well, I mean, I'm thinking like 4 APs next year, around 1 or 2.
If you think calculus next year, are you gonna take AP or BC? Okay. Yeah, don't take BC. They say it's 1 chapter, it's 2 chapters, and it's a really hard chapter, and you have to go all. It's not worth it. I learned that the hard way. That's why I'm failing.
Sorry about that, Calvin.
It's okay, Ryan.
What about you? Yeah, what do you think, Ryan?
Look when the name came to Ryan.
what kind of fears do you think are just like hanging over your life that are like controlling your choices and just the overall thought process?
Family. Because like my family's so like, they want to plan my own future. Like they say, oh, you should go here. Oh, well, you shouldn't go there because they don't have blah, blah, blah. Oh, you shouldn't go there because they don't have good baseball team. Well, I want to choose. Don't choose for me. I want to go where I want to go. So it's kind of hard having my family choosing where I want to go for college. So it's kind of,
where do you want to go?
I'm going to Ohio. I got a scholarship there, but they don't want me to come. So.
Is it a full ride?
Yeah. Dude, I take it. They're like, no, it's not a good baseball team. Okay,
well, are you going to play baseball professionally?
Probably not. No chance.
I mean, you got a chance. But
it's like 0.1%.
So you can be a 0.1%? You can.
Would you go and play baseball there in Ohio?
Yeah, that's why I got a 4-H4. So, but it's like a D6.
Yeah. And then like doing student athletes kind of hard.
Yeah.
But isn't it a little bit easier at the lower divisions because they like allow it more to?
Yeah.
If you're at a higher division, it's like harder.
Mm-hmm. Higher division is like way harder, like UCLA.
Yeah.
But it's not cool to know, like telling you like where you need to go and stuff. Like it is your choice.
Yeah.
It's your life.
Yeah. It's like, okay.
There's something where you like you should get an L. Listen to their like advice and what they have to say, and maybe take it into consideration, but don't completely go there.
Yeah.
Like if that's where they think you should go, and that's also where you want to go, then I don't know. But like go where you want to go, and they'll place that's gonna make you the happiest, and like, because that's the next step of your life, and that's like really where you become your person, and like who you're gonna be for the rest of your life. So you need to go where you think it's gonna make you the best person, or you're gonna have the most fun. Or I mean, if you want to party, I'll let you go to Santa Barbara with
Matt. I love Matt. Yeah.
He's gonna be drunk all the time. No, he's gonna be fine. He won't drink.
He's gonna do it. Yeah. How about you, Cole?
What?
Cole?
Yeah, I will buy it. I didn't answer the question.
Yeah, you did answer.
Yeah, no, he already did.
Yeah, Ryan.
Sorry.
Come on, Ryan.
Go on, Chad.
She knows my name.
He's been lying on all his papers.
It's Chad. We all know it's Chad.
Wait, pull your birth certificate out real quick.
Hey, get off your phone.
Hey, man.
Did you mean your other Chad?
Well, basically, this paragraph right here was saying, like, what kind of giants are you facing today? And that's kind of what we just, you know, said. And have you got, like, a mountain or an obstacle that needs to be moved and you cannot do it? But the thing is, like, we may not be able to, like, really focus in and, like, take control of all the situations in life, but we just need to, like, take God as, like, our stronghold and our refuge, you know? But I have another question. Like, do you think that that area that you're, like, really struggling with, do you think that's a place where you can let God come in and take control, or is that more harder for you to just let him come in?
Chad Hoskins, born 2001.
Doctor, enter your name here.
Doctor, last name, last name.
But anyway, back to the question. Like, do you think that's an area where you can allow God to come in, or is that more like of a tougher situation where you think, like, he doesn't play a big role?
I mean, I should trust in God more to provide the finances for college, because he'll put me where he wants me to go. But it's like a hard thing to do, because it's, I'm getting judged on what I did in the past, like my grades to get into college and stuff, and then I have to put in all the work to write the essays for scholarships, and then I have to be good at writing essays, which is not. To get all the money, and it's not as easy to trust God and stuff where I have to put in all the work. Because, like, it's me. Like, in my head, it's, I need to do this, I need to do this, and there's not much. Alright, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to trust God to get this done for me. Like, I can't do that. I can't trust God to write this. That'd be great, but I don't know what happened.
That's kind of the same with me with the academics and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, I'm the one putting all the effort and stuff. Like, because when I start thinking of, you know, oh, I'm going to trust God, he's going to help me get this done, it's almost like me starting to slack off and, like, not put as much stress on that one thing.
Yeah.
And then I end up doing as well, or, like, not getting it done very quality. Like,
yeah.
That makes sense. So,
I mean, like, at times it's easy, and like, other times it's harder. Like, sometimes it's just, like, well, I like school and stuff, and just, like, I'll just go around, and then it's more of, like, focusing on God every day, not, like, instead of, like, not always just, like, give God this to me, it's always, I, like, forget to focus on him, when I need to focus on him, like, he's there all the time, not, like, he's just there when I pray, it's more of something like that.
I feel like for your situation, it might be harder, too, because it's, like, you said you're having trouble, like, fitting in and stuff, like, that can be really easy in slipping into, like, trying to be what other people want you to be in order to fit into their group. But it's like, you have to be who God wants you to be, and that's just yourself, you know?
Yeah.
Mine would probably be sports or my family, because my family, they want to choose where I want to go to college or where they want me to go to college. Like, I have scholarships to three different places, but
they don't want me to go to the one I want to go to. So it's kind of hard for me to, like, got into that part.
But the next question I have is, like, those fears that you did, that you guys just said, like, do you think that that's something that you can let, that you can trust God to handle? Or, like, is that something where you can let God into that area of your life and take control? Would you say it's, like, really hard for you to do?
Let Ryan go first, because me and Madre here. Shut up. Anyways, it's hard for God before. Shut up! Anyways.
How you telling me?
Shut up!
Sorry.
Shut up!
Colin, be quiet. It's disrespectful.
Thank you, Cole. Anyways.
Sorry, Ryan.
We're laughing about Chad. Anyways.
Sorry, Ryan.
Okay, anyways. Before I was really interrupted by, you know, Cole. I mean, Colin. And Cole. And Chad. don't say anything! Anyways. it's hard for to let God part of my family because he could show me like what colleges he wants me to go to, like which ones I shouldn't and should go to. But I feel like it would be hard to let him in that part because I don't know if he'll want me to go to the college I dream of going to, so it would be hard for me. Yeah. Right, so,
I mean, I don't know. Well, like I was saying, I feel like it's not really right or, like, their decision for them to, like, tell you what college you want to go to or, like, what path you want to go down. Mm-hmm. So that's your life, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, they could have some good advice.
Yeah.
They could have some good things to say. But it is ultimately your decision.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. But basically, just in this devotion just goes on to say that, like, the Lord is in the obstacle-moving business. Like, with one flick of the wrist, God can use a young shepherd boy to kill a giant to save his people, which is what happened in this situation, you know? And so just don't let fear keep you from, you know, making the better decisions or, like, just from the way of life God wants you to live. That's the biggest thing. And so if you guys will read a prayer with me, just in spirit, Ryan, over here.
Yeah.
Oh, you just got Ryan.
I know. So, you guys want to repeat after me? That'd be cool. So, today, I will trust in the Lord.
I will trust in the Lord.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
And lean not on my own understanding.
And lean not on my own understanding.
I choose to follow my faith.
I choose to follow my faith
and not my fear.
And not my fear.
Lord, help me to discern.
Lord, help me to discern
the truth from the lie.
The truth from the lie.
With you directing my path.
With you directing my path.
I will walk in my God-given destiny.
I will walk in my God-given destiny.
In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
I'm starting to think.
No, that's good. Ryan messed this up before.